ABC News, exclusive. U.S. may have let dozens of terrorists into the country as refugees. Several dozen suspected terrorist bombers, including some believed to have targeted American troops, may have mistakenly been allowed to move to the United States as war refugees, according to FBI agents investigating the remnants of roadside bombs recovered from Iraq and Afghanistan. The discovery in 2009 of two Al-Qaeda Iraq terrorists living as refugees in Bowling Green, Kentucky, Rand Paul even brought this up, who later admitted in court that they'd attacked U.S. soldiers in Iraq, prompted the Bureau to assign hundreds of specialists to an around-the-clock effort aimed at checking its archive of 100,000 improvised explosive devices collected in the war zones, known as IEDs, for other suspected terrorist fingerprints. By the way, you know who built those IEDs? The Iranians, who Obama just cut a deal with and gave $150 billion to. Quote, "We are currently supporting dozens of current counterterrorism investigations like that." Dozens. FBI agent Gregory Carl, director of the Terrorist Explosive Device Analytical Center, said in an ABC News interview to be broadcast tonight. "I wouldn't be surprised if there were many more than that," said House Committee on Homeland Security Chairman Michael McCaul. "And these are trained terrorists in the art of bomb making that are inside the United States. And quite frankly, from a homeland security perspective, that really concerns me." So why doesn't it really concern Barack Obama? Or really concern Hillary Clinton? As a result of the Kentucky case, the State Department stopped processing Iraq refugees for 6 months in 2011, federal officials told ABC News. Even for many who had heroically helped U.S. forces as interpreters and intelligence assets. So why aren't we stopping the Syrians for at least 6 months? One Iraqi who had aided American troops was assassinated before his refugee application could be processed because of the immigration delays. Two U.S. officials said in 2011, fewer than 10,000 Iraqis were resettled as refugees in the U.S., half the number from the year before. An intelligence tip initially led the FBI to Wad Ramadwan Awan, 32, in 2009. The Iraqi had claimed to be a refugee who faced persecution back home, a story that shattered when the FBI found his fingerprints on a cordless phone base that U.S. soldiers dug up in a gravel pile south of Baji, that's in Iraq, on September 1, 2005. So now we have to rely on happenstance, and we might dig up something that has somebody's fingerprints on it? The phone base had been wired to an unexploded bomb buried in a nearby road. An ABC News investigation of the flawed U.S. refugee screening system. Did you hear that? Of the flawed U.S. refugee screening program. But Obama says it's robust, which was overhauled 2 years ago. Oh, it's still robust. Good to know. Showed that Awan was mistakenly allowed in the U.S. and resettled in the leafy southern town of Bowling Green, Kentucky. Most of the more than 70,000 Iraqi war refugees in the U.S. are law-abiding immigrants eager to start. Why do they have to write that? Most of them are law-abiding. I think we know that. That's not the problem. The problem's not the law-abiding. The problem's the rest. But the FBI discovered that Awan had been arrested in Kirkuk, Iraq in 2006 and confessed on video made of his interrogation that he was an insurgent, according to the U.S. military and FBI, and it goes on. Department of Homeland Security spokesman Peter Bugard said in a statement that the U.S. government continually improves and expands its procedures for vetting immigrants, refugees, and visa applicants, and today the vetting process considers a far broader range of information than it did in past years. Yeah. Are you a terrorist? Did they figure out to ask that question? Are you a would-be terrorist? Our procedures continue to check applicants' names and fingerprints against records of individuals known to be security threats. Well, what if you don't have records? Including the terrorist watch list or of law enforcement concern. These checks are vital to advance. All right, whatever. Last year, a Department of Homeland Security senior intelligence official testified in a House hearing that Awan and Hamadi's names and fingerprints were checked by the FBI, DHS, and the Defense Department during the vetting process in 2009 and came up clean. We cannot ensure the security of your family. This government cannot ensure the security of your family through some robust vetting process. That is a fact. And so what's happening now is Obama and Hillary Clinton and the Democrats, they're willing to apparently potentially sacrifice American lives to politics, to an ideology. And that's a fact.